seven S's. And the last one is by Carl Benedict.
Hi, welcome once again, everyone. Thank you so much for joining us at Gallery 1516 in our Bagels and Sometimes Bach program. My name is Sarah Billmeyer. I'm the deputy director here, and I'd like to thank you all for joining us. If this is your first time at Gallery 1516, we are a nonprofit organization that supports and celebrates Nebraska and regional artists. And that includes not only visual arts, like our current photography exhibition, but musicians, writers, architects, graphic design, basically any and all forms of the arts. We have a fantastic program of Bagels and Bach still left this fall. There is a schedule of events card which is on the table by the front door, so be sure to grab one of those. We have four more performances left this fall. More information about that program, as well as our current exhibition, can be found on our website, gallery1516.org. We also send out updates via email, so if you don't yet get our emails, be sure to put down your email address in the sign-in book at the front desk as well, so you can stay up to date on all of that. A fantastic way to support the fantastic programs we have here at Gallery 1516 is via membership. I recognize many of our members here today, so thank you once again for joining us. Your membership fees go directly to programs like Bagels and Sometimes Bach, as well as our visual art exhibitions. We never take commission fees from artwork sales, so 100% of the sale price goes directly to the artist. We also pay our musicians who perform at Bagels and Bach as well. So once again, thank you for joining as a member. We also accept donations. So if you're interested in that, please see us at the front desk after the show and we can tell you more about that. But without further ado, I'll turn things over to our fantastic Opera Omaha performance today. It's a real crowd favorite, so you're in for a treat as always. To introduce Opera Omaha, please join me in welcoming Lauren Medici.
We are in our seventh year of partnership with Gallery 1516 and these performances as part of Bagels and Sometimes Bach, and it's been a really wonderful partnership as two organizations who really believe in supporting artists and supporting artists here in our Omaha community. Today we have a really wonderful program for you with Mary Evelyn Hangley and Josh Quinn. Mary Evelyn was here with us. You may have seen her last weekend performing in Don Giovanni. She was Donna Elvira. And Josh Quinn is our head of music and also chorus director, so also deeply involved with that show, although you never saw him on stage. This last week, we have been doing about 10 different artist visits all across Omaha with schools and community partners, and it's just been a delight to be in those spaces with both Josh and Mary. And so I'm so grateful to be there. If Opera Omaha is new to you, you can see us a couple more times. We do about 200 community events a year, and that includes concerts like this. We will be at Lauritsen Gardens twice as part of their Holiday Lights celebration on November 27th and December 27th, as well as we will have a special program at the Jocelyn Museum on December 5th as part of their Knights of the Jocelyn program, celebrating their European collection. So those are three more opportunities to see us before the end of the year. And then of course, we will be back in February for our main stage opera, The Rake's Progress, and we'll have programming surrounding that in January and February. So not that you're looking forward to the winter months, but can be something to look forward to in those colder, darker months. So we're delighted to be here today. I'm so grateful to all of you for coming out, as you always do, for Bagels and Sometimes Bach. And without further ado, I'll introduce our fabulous artist, Mary Evelyn and Josh Quinn.
This morning, some of the biggest pieces in the song repertoire, the four last songs by Richard Strauss, are the pinnacle of vocal literature. I have declined performing them for years, and when Mary Evelyn proposed this program, I figured it was time to do them. They're mammoth for the pianist, or originally orchestra, and even more so for the singer. On top of the vocal demands, the gravity of the text is really something that cannot be overlooked. We have included translations today in the program. I encourage you to read along as the performance is happening. The gravity of the text really informed Strauss as he was writing them. He had already set several songs by both poets, Eichendorff and Hasse, but these songs, these poems, spoke to him in an extremely profound way. He wrote them in 1948, only about a year, a little bit less than a year before he passed away. And one can almost assume that he knew his end was near as he was writing them, as you'll hear from the way that he sets the poetry. They're gorgeous songs, but even more deeply profound and important in the repertoire. So I hope you enjoy them. Imagine an orchestra rather than the piano. He originally wrote them for orchestra and soprano soloist, but we couldn't fit an orchestra into today. So I hope you enjoy them. It's a pleasure and a privilege to get to collaborate with Mary Evelyn Hangley. She's a fantastic singer. We met about 11 years ago, so this feels sort of full circle, getting to have her back in Omaha and to collaborate on this wonderful recital. So I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
one way that I thought it should go. And Mary suggested the way that the program is printed today.
It'll make sense.
It's challenging for anyone to, as performers, to try to do anything after that. But I believe we will all leave today a little bit more uplifted with the program order that Mary Evelyn's proposed. So that was, as I mentioned, the four last songs by Strauss, pinnacle of the soprano, of the vocal repertoire. But now for something a little bit lighter, pieces you might not be familiar with. A composer who wrote a ton of vocal music, but unfortunately is more known for her instrumental writing, Cécile Chaminade. It's interesting to note that both Strauss and Chaminade were alive pretty much the exact, their dates are very, very close, but their music couldn't be any further apart. Chaminade, born in Paris, to a very musical family. Her parents were musicians. Her mother was her very first piano teacher. At the age of 5, she started taking piano lessons and was a musical prodigy, started composing at a very young age. However, her success was really diminished in Paris during her life. People overlooked her writing. There was a lot of sexism of the time. People didn't really value female composers during that time period, specifically in France. So she moved around quite a bit and garnished some more notoriety in different countries, but really became a hit in the United States when she came to the US for a tour performing some of her music, but just performing. She sort of came onto the scene and blew up in the North, the Northeast. Even so much so that people created Chaminade clubs, really to champion her music, but also to feature female composers of the time. And some of those clubs still exist in Rhode Island specifically. I encourage you to check out the Chaminade clubs in the Northeast. It's very interesting how their history came about and wonderful impact that they had on young, very, very talented female composers and really pushed their works into the musical world. Chaminade was a virtuosic pianist, so sometimes her piano accompaniments for her art songs as well as her instrumental writings are essentially a concerto unto themselves, but they are just there to serve the to highlight the text that Chaminade composed for the voice. You'll hear a wide variety of styles in these four songs. Some of her more popular songs, but again, her works aren't as popular as Strauss, so even if these are the most popular within her canon, they may still be new to you. So we have a wide variety of musical styles. We have the text for these songs in the program as well. I encourage you to read along and see how Chaminade does very masterful word painting. Things that you read, you can hear sort of come alive off of the musical page. So I'm very excited to present a much lighter portion of the program, and I hope you enjoy them, and I hope this is bringing to light a composer who might be new to you, so you can go and further explore her compositions. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.